Hey everybody, it's Amy Astro here and welcome back to my channel. Do you know what today is? Well, today is the day that I am no longer going to be Chicken Little. I am going to install the Celestron focus motor. So let's get started. So before I get started on installing the Celestron focus motor, I want to thank everyone for their comments in the last video. I appreciate all of those ideas. They are wonderful. They have me thinking about, you know, how I'm setting things up, and I really appreciate hearing everybody else's experiences with the RASA. So I'm really getting excited. We are getting close, very, very close. In fact, I have my BMAX computer hooked up right now, going through all the Windows updates that took place over the last year since I've used it. So that's going to take a day or so before I can even get onto that computer. But let's get that focus motor started. Well guys, here's the focus motor. And it's not a really big box, but this box was intimidating when I first took a peek on the inside. And let's get it open. We've got the instructions. And we have a bunch of different cables, screwdrivers, adapters, and then underneath we've got the focus motor. But let me tell you what, these instructions were intimidating. And they were intimidating because I was looking at how many pages there were. I was like, ooh, I need to be awake today to do this. But you know what? When you open this up and you look, it's only one page. The rest of it is everything written in different languages. So I was probably worried about nothing. Okay. Well, guys, I finally opened up the box and these are all the pieces that I found. We have the Celestron motor itself that will fit onto the telescope. We have two adapters here. One is for the larger Schmidt-Cassegrain telescopes, like the 11 inch and above. And this guy is for the smaller Schmidt-Cassegrains and will work perfectly on my RASA 8 inch. It also comes with the cable that's intended to plug into if you had an AVX mount. It has an adapter collar here for the smaller telescopes, and I'm going to be needing that also. It'll fit on the shaft. Comes with a small grub screw, set screw, another screw, and it includes all of our tools, the Allen key, the wrench, and the screwdriver. Now the first thing we need to do is to put our telescope in the vertical position. And that is just so gravity is in our favor, and it will help us keep everything nice and flush. And the second thing we need to do is to remove the rubber sleeve off of the original focuser. Now, this is held on by friction. It is not easy to get out. You could use a flathead screwdriver to pry this off with you like, or you can really muscle it out and get it to pull off, which, as you see, is not really easy. There we go. And it pops right off. And just put this back in the box because you're not going to be needing it anymore. Now, on the inside of this orange ring, there are three screws. Those three screws, we need to go ahead and remove them and save them for later because we're going to use them again. All right, and we're just going to lift this orange plate off. And we're not going to need him again. Just put him back in the box. The next step is for us to determine which of these two adapter plates we are going to need. Now, one of them clearly has a larger diameter hole. This is for the larger telescopes like the 11 and the 14. Or you have this one here, which has a smaller hole and has a bite taken out of it, kind of like a Pac-Man. And this is the one that we need for the 8-inch and smaller. And we're going to set it on here and align it up with the previous three screw holes. Now we want to make sure that we put the screws in just a little bit at each time and keep rotating around the circle. We want to make sure that this stays perfectly flush. We don't want anything cattywampus on here because it will cause binding later on with your focus motor, and that is not good. So let's get those three screws back in. So while I'm taking the time to tighten down each one of these screws incrementally all the way around, I want to take a moment and look down the shaft here and make sure that it remains perfectly centered inside this inner circle. And you can go ahead and give it a little nudge and make sure that it doesn't move in any one direction. Now it will move some in the very beginning, but as you get these tightened down, it will stop moving. All right, now you don't have to get all muscle man and tighten these down super tight. They just need to be tight enough that this plate is not going to move. All right, so that looks good. It's perfectly centered. I'm going to give this a nudge. It is not moving. So on to the next step. Okay, now over here on our focus motor, if you look at this side, you have an arrow and you have this little half circle of white here, which is the range. The goal is you want this arrow to be in the middle of this range. And what that does is it helps you access some of these other screws that might be hidden by the body. So we are going to take the included wrench and we are going to put it on here and we're going to crank this guy down. Now listen, there you go, until he is about in the range. There you go. So that is now all lined up. All right, so now we're going to come back onto this back side now that this screw is available to us. This is called the clamping screw, and we are going to loosen it up a couple turns just slightly. Okay, now with that done, we're going to flip this over. And since I have these smaller RASA 8, I'm going to need this adapter sleeve so it will fit on the focusing shaft. And you'll see that it has a little tab on here. And that tab is going to line up here in this little hole. So I'm going to take this and we're going to drop it in just like so. And included in with that sleeve was a small screw. And we are going to attach it down right there. Let's get this in. There we go. Okay, now next to that clamping screw, there is a set screw hole, which is for this grub screw that they included. I'm going to attach it here to the wrench that they gave me. And let's install it in here. Now you just need to get it in just slightly. You don't want to crank it down too much because we're going to adjust all that later. All right, so now I've got all of that done. All right, so now that we have taken the time to prep the focus motor, it is time for us to place it on the telescope. Now, if you notice across the top here, we have a whole bunch of different screw holes, and that is so we can rotate this in any direction that works for our particular rig. And on the top here, there are two screws in the back. They are their captured screws, and those are the ones that will fit in here. So let's go ahead and place this down. And let's see, I can place it this way, or I can move it over this way. I'll probably hit it on something. Now I could have it aiming up if I want. And this would be great if I had all of my cables coming up to the top. But I'm thinking that my dew heater controller and everything where this will be wired to will probably lay on the bottom rail. So I'm gonna go ahead and just insert it in this direction. Let's take our wrench and get these screws in one of these sets of holes. You can lift it up slightly. You can see the screw coming out the bottom, and that will help you line it up in one of these holes. Now, as you're putting this in, make sure you keep this nice and flush with the surface, okay? Again, we don't want to tighten down one screw or the other and have this sitting crooked. And we want to avoid anything that would cause this to bind. So I'm going to go ahead and tighten these down. All right, now I've got these partially tightened. I'm going to come around here. We're going to go to the screw that's down here, and we're going to go ahead and tighten it up some. And I'm going to tighten down that set screw that's holding on to the center post. And let's continue on with the top ones. All right, let's see if we did that. There's no wiggle in there. Everything seems really secure. All right, now if we look at the bottom side of this focus motor, you are going to see that it has several different types of connections. Now, this one, you can connect it to either a 12-volt power supply, or you can connect it via the USB port to the computer, and that will also feed it power. Or you can feed it to the auxiliary port on your telescope mount if you have the Celestron AVX mounts. And when you're not in use, you just plug the holes, and you don't have to worry about any moisture getting into them. So it's really nice having these plugs already included. I tend to end up putting gaffer's tape on these ports when I'm not using them. So it's nice having the connectors here. But so as you guys see, this really was not that hard to install. It was a lot easier than I thought it was, and I was intimidated by the number of pages in the manual. Reality was, they just translated it into a whole bunch of languages, and it was really quite easy to follow. What was nice is they gave me options on which orientation I wanted the focus motor at, so that was great. I've got options on how I want to power this. I can power it using a Celestron AVX mount, which I don't have. I've also got a USB 2 port, and I have a 12-volt option. Hey guys, before I finish this video off, I want to do something new at the end of them. You know how I always include pictures of my Astro cats doing something fun and silly? Well, I want to start seeing your Astro pets, okay? So send me an email. I've got the address down below. And share me some pictures and some video clips of your Astro pet doing something fun. Let me know their name, what type of animal they are, what state or country they're in. You know, anything you want me to know about your pet, and I'll include it in the video. So this week we are going to start off with an adorable Astro pup whose name is Sophie. And Sophie, oh, she is just the cutest pup. And she lives in Spain. So hang tight for the end of the video so you all can meet Sophie. Well guys, I want to thank you for following me along on this journey. Thank you so much for sharing your comments with me, letting me know what pitfalls you all fell into and how I can possibly avoid them. That's just great. I do appreciate the comments. Don't worry about if you guys are mansplaining, because you're really not. I do appreciate it, okay? But guys, don't forget to like, subscribe, share my videos with all your Astro friends. Help me build this community stronger and bigger. And let's sign off, okay? I'm Amy Astro, wishing you guys some great health, clear skies, and remember, I love each and every one of y'all. Goodbye, y'all.